Hello once again, readers of good books. My name is Nick Pell, and this is once again coming from my white room. Now today I am going to be reviewing a book which is not a James Cesantes book for the first time in quite a while. This is a book that I read in my lit class in college, and it is Louise Erdrich's The Roundhouse. This is a book which won the National Book Award in, I think, 2012, and so I had to read it, and I'm going to review it right now. I'll be talking about the end of the book towards the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. If you have read the book and you want to know how it ends and my thoughts on how it ends, stay tuned for that, and I'll be talking about it there. Now, the book follows through the eyes of a 13-year-old boy named Joe. His mother has been raped and beaten. That's how the book opens up. And they live on a Native American reservation. And they are Native American. And because this crime occurred on Native property, and the perpetrator was not Native himself, the justice system doesn't really apply to it. And this is like legit stuff that she uses for this book. And it's a very big problem because Joe's father is very much trying to find out who did this person and see if there's any way that the person can be prosecuted. It really doesn't seem like there is going to be a way to do it. And it's very interesting in that aspect of the plot. So there's a lot of different characters in this book. The story bounces between finding out who did the crime and locating clues and going between kind of a mystery-esque point of view into Joe hanging out with his friends and being a regular teenager during a summer vacation from school. And it's very interesting to see the dynamics of the story change in that aspect. And there's, like I said, a plethora of different characters in the story. I don't really want to get into all of them because it would make for a long video, and I've had way too many of those recently. That is kind of the general plot of the story. We have Joe trying to find out who has raped and beaten his mother. His mother is at the point where she is so mentally scarred by this and fearful for some individuals who she thinks would be harmed if she talks about the crime that happened, that she won't tell them who did this to her. And that's how the story goes for much of the, at least the first half of the book, is that as Joe and his father are figuring out more and more clues and aspects and things to look into, she is literally in her room, in her bed, kind of just drying out and starving away because she won't eat. She just sleeps all day, and it's a very bad situation. I suppose one other kind of central character to the story is Cappy, who is Joe's friend and really good friend. And towards the end of the story, he ends up in love with a girl named Zelina. And it's a very funny situation because just of how it occurs. I won't really spoil it for you guys, but it's just a cool situation, and he becomes a very interesting and important character towards the very end chapters of the story. Another main character is Sonia, and she is kind of like this aunt-esque figure in Joe's life. She's a very cool aunt. It's where Joe goes to kind of hang out, and he works in her shop for a good chunk of the book, and he grows this relationship with this woman who treats him like a human being, and like an adult in a lot of aspects, but also knows that he is still a child. There's a point in the story where they come across a large sum of money, and she has a very creative way of maintaining that amount of money. They go to a bunch of different banks throughout the area and deposit a certain amount of cash into it in different checking accounts in order to make sure that the money can't really be traced as one whole item. And so that's very interesting. And she has kind of a dark past, kind of a messed up past, so that's really interesting when that gets into it. And there's just a lot of Native American culture which is put into this story, which is really interesting to see and learn about throughout the course of the novel. And so getting into kind of the themes of the book, well, obviously, one is justice. Is there going to be justice for Joe's mother, or is she just going to have to suffer for the rest of her life, and the criminal will get away with the crime without any punishment whatsoever. Another one is the idea of evil, in this case, evil spirits. In one of the points in the story, someone tells a story of Nanapush, and he is this kind of spiritual elder-esque person, talks about when he was a young man, and dives into the idea of evil spirits possessing people and forcing them to do bad things. And that is kind of used throughout the novel as an explanation for some people's actions. And so it's the kind of idea between good and evil, which is really touched on throughout the book. Third one could be trust. Just the idea of trusting someone with certain information and then deciding whether or not that person will stay true to their promises. And then lastly, the idea of adolescence and growing up and growing up and maturing very, very quickly in this new adult world in which you find yourself. Those are some of the themes in the book. In terms of enjoyment, I very much enjoyed The Roundhouse. It was an interesting story. Like I said, I was forced to read it for class, so it's not really something that I would have picked up normally, but I'm glad that I did. I think it's a very interesting book, something that a lot of people should read because it is. It touches on very important topics, and it's something which, in my opinion, is an important thing to know about and maybe try to get some stuff fixed in terms of the justice system in this aspect. At this point, I'm going to talk about the ending of the novel really quickly. So, if you have not read the book, know that I am going to spoil some stuff. So, know that there will be an annotation down here saying where to jump to in terms of getting to the very end of the review. So, it is revealed eventually that Lyndon Lark is the perpetrator behind his mother's crime, and this basically infuriates Joe, and for a very, I guess, short amount of time, he comes up with a plan of revenge and realizes that Lyndon is just going to simply get away with the crime that he has committed, and so Joe sees it necessary to kill the guy. And so he steals a hunting rifle with help from Cappy and basically finds out that Lyndon goes to the golf course a fair amount of time to golf, obviously. And Joe waits there, kind of on a part of the golf course, which he can see the first hole, and eventually Lyndon does show up, and Joe shoots him once in the stomach, which causes Lyndon a huge amount of pain, and then Cappy ends up finishing the job. He comes up behind Joe, takes the rifle from his hands, and shoots the guy in the head. So in the last chapter of the novel, it's kind of the resolution of the whole thing. Joe and Cappy are discussing the event and trying to make sure that they're not going to be tied to it at all. They basically destroy the rifle and spread it all over the place. Yeah, towards the very end of the story, Cappy and Joe decide to go off and try to find Zelia and get Cappy reunited with her. As they're driving off, you think it's going to be a happy thing, everyone's going to survive, happy days. The car crashes because Joe falls asleep at the wheel and Cappy is flung out and killed. Yeah, that's basically where it ends. Joe's parents come and find him at the hospital and drive him home. And he mentions that there's a spot that he always used to stop when going into town to get ice cream. And they don't stop at it because he's not a child anymore. By this point in the story, he has the mindset of an adult because of all these things that he has had to deal with over the course of this summer and the course of this novel. So it's a very interesting ending in that aspect. Those are my thoughts on The Roundhouse. Leave your thoughts on it down below if you have read it, and I would love to hear that. Like, favorite, comment, and subscribe if you so choose. I'd appreciate it immensely. Make sure to go and buy my short story, The Bridge, which the link is down in the description, and I would appreciate that a whole lot. And so, as always, my good people, my name is Nick Bell, and once again, keep on reading. Round and round and round.